What's going on YouTube? This is VanCat11 and I'm here at Range USA because I wanted to shoot my Canik Mete MC9 before I send it in to NC Engravers. NC Engravers is going to actually be recording a video and putting it on their YouTube channel, and I just want to shoot it before I send it in. So I'm here. I've got the flat dark earth version. Don't know what we're actually going to be doing with it yet, but there should be a video coming soon, and I'll probably link it up with this one. This way you can see it probably and hopefully at the same time that NC Engravers lets their video out on the project for the Mete MC9. So stay tuned, and thank you guys again for tuning in. I really appreciate you guys. Go ahead and like, subscribe if you haven't done so already, to keep up with new videos that do come out. And take care of each other. I'll see you guys next time. So right now, excuse me, right now I'm trying to zero in on the 407K. Try to get that on point. I'm shooting a blazer 115 grain to start. Yeah, I'm on. All right. Alright, so those are the last shots. These are the first 50 shots. As you can see right here, that's okay at 7 yards. Everything's all 7 yards. That was just awful. But yeah, 7 yards.
I'm gonna try these American Gunner. this is a 124 grain XTP.
Yeah, you know me.
10 yards. I don't remember when's the last time I came shooting. It's been a while. I'm a little rusty, and especially shooting the MC9. It's a smaller platform, so it's snappier. Do 10 rounds at 10 yards. Still anticipating a lot. Yeah. Started off good, but That anticipation just keeps coming back. 9. 10 again. This is the Canik Mete MC9. Very small. I mean, it's compared to the Elite Executive. I love carrying the Executive. I don't know if I'll switch. In all fairness, the MC9 has the 407K, and the Executive has the Chichicon SRO. Rushed it. It's a lot better. Plus it's comped. It's comped.
So this is where my audio went out, so I want to explain what's going on right here, because at the bottom two targets were with the executive, so I had tighter groups, and I had two flyers down because of that anticipation kept coming in, but the top three targets were with the Mete MC9, and right here I'm just showing my executive down at the bottom, and the top targets were shot with the Mete MC9.
This is a little bit past 10 yards with the Mete MC9. What's up here? So it's better, it's just not great. Well, in any case, I don't know. I still need to, I'm used to running my executive because it's badass. I just brought it up so I could go ahead and shoot it again before I send it in. So that's how it looks now. This is how it looks now. and then you'll see it transforms into something different when I send it out to NC Engravers. All right, so stay tuned for that, and I'll see you guys later.
What's up, YouTube? This is VanCat11. Thank you for tuning in. I just received a new package from NC Engravers. What he did was wanted to do a new design for the Canik Mete MC9. And so he reached out to me, I sent it in, and I didn't know actually what he was going to be doing, or I didn't have any insight. I just told him, go ahead and do your thing, because I do have a lot of faith in your work, and excellent work. Now, before I open up the box, I want to show you what he's actually done for me in the past. And once I got my first one back, I knew that this was the person that I wanted to do my firearms going forward. One of the ones that he did, let me put this to the side. One of the ones that he did was the Canik Rival. And what he did was he did the Cerakote job on that with the Cerakote on the stock trigger and the Taylor Freelance backstrap. This is a brass backstrap. And what I wanted was, this color is actually copper. It might look orange to some of you, but this is actually copper and black. This is a battle-worn finish. So that was one of the projects that he did for me. Another one that he did was the TP9 SFX. He did another battle-worn, what I call the tuxedo, because it's black and it's white. Most of you will probably know it as the bitone, I believe. And so I kept the slide black, and I had him do the white battle-worn finish on it. He also did the Taylor Freelance Magwell, and I opted to stay black with the Taylor Freelance brass backstrap for the TP9 SFX. So this is another one that he did for me. He also did the barrel, which is a nickel coating, I believe. But he also did the barrel for that. So this is another one that he did for me. Another one that he did was when he first wanted to do the ray cuts. I think it's the ray cuts, it's what it's called on the webpage, was the ray cuts for the TP9 SF Elite. And this was the first firearm that he did the cut for, the Canik at least. So he did that, he did the slide. I have the optic off right now because I don't use this one as, I used to carry this one, but I don't anymore. I carry my executive, which I'll show you in just a moment. So I took off the optic so I could put it on the Mete MC9 and run that. But yeah, this is another one that he did with these cuts right here on the top. He also did my SIG P320 custom. The only thing that he did with this one was the slide. He did the coloring because I had purchased this off of eBay, this slide, and it was just a raw metal finish. So he did this, I forget what it's called, it's, midnight bronze with battle-worn finish, copper undertone. And he also did the barrel for it as well, which is, let me put this down right there. And he did this barrel as well. So he colored this. This color, I believe, is no longer one of their options, but I think he had this barrel, and I think I purchased it from him. Yeah, that's what happened. He had this barrel already coated, and I just purchased it from him directly, but he doesn't offer this color anymore. So that goes with that. So this was another first for the Canik line. This was the first slide that he did with the TP9 Elite Combat Executive with the side windows right here. This one is a popular design for, well, throughout all of the firearms that he does them for, but I was really happy that I was actually the first one to get this slide cut, and since then I've seen so many other Canics with the side windows, but this is pretty much one of my favorite cuts from that NC Engravers offers. It's got the SRO, TLR7A. He also did I don't know if you can tell, but it's a black and gold battle-worn finish. Let's see if you can get that. Yeah, so he did the, I wanted the black and gold battle-worn finish to go along with the side barrel to match along with it. And this is what I carry now. This is my favorite. Well, yeah, so now since I've showed you everything that he's done for me, all of these, by the way, are clear. Just to show you guys, everything is clear. Put everything down to the side so that we can get to the Canik Mete MC9. Should have done this at the beginning, but I knew they were all clear. So let me get this out of the way. Now for the unveiling for the Mete MC9. I just actually got this. I got this yesterday, but I wasn't able to open it. I wasn't home. I didn't know actually that it got here. But last night, Friday at 8 Eastern time, he released the video for this firearm and the service that he's going to be providing. Now, right now, I would, if I were you, if you haven't already, go ahead and join their email list, because right now he's offering 20% off this service for the, and I think it's for other services as well, but he's offering this service for the Mete MC9, which is going to actually be debuting on Monday. So I got the back straps back, and I know that you probably saw that on the video last night. If you follow NC Engravers, if not, go ahead and follow NC Engravers on YouTube.com or YouTube. This is the base pad. This is called Ghost. It's the color that they came up with for on their own, I guess. Everything looks really good. Looks really good. A little dirty there, but I had sent in all of the parts that I could that came with the MC9. Just like all these parts. This is actually the Freedom Smith base pad that got lucky, because I think Freedom Smith doesn't offer them all the time. I think once they sell out, he'll make more. And then they sell out and he'll make more. So I got lucky and I purchased this. This used to be tungsten, but I sent this in so that he can go ahead and color match it to the slide. So I'm really stoked on how this came out. It really looks nice. I like this color. It really looks cool. This is the main part, and as usual, they'll send a little snack, some candies, their business card. Put that to the side. NC Engravers Firearm Services, with all the information, Mark and Lisa Moore. Yes, definitely. Once you get your cut work from them, go ahead and give them a good review. And don't forget to oil, or don't forget to double check your screws for tightness. But he does mention in the video that he recommends that you oil all of your the product that you get back for, that you sent into them. Now, yeah, it says right there, be sure to oil lube the slide and frame prior to reassembly. I'll be doing that off camera, but this is it. Finally, in my hand, the Canik Mete MC9. Wow, that looks awesome. Put that away. What I did like about him and his video is that he explains how detailed or how he meticulously observed the slide and what he could or could not do. This is, I don't even know what he called this service, just side window cut service for the MC9. But this is amazing. It looks pretty cool. Dare I say it looks cute, but it also looks badass. So I'm really happy with it. I can't wait to take it out to the range and fire it. Now what I'm gonna do is just break this down. So I went ahead and take it off. And what I enjoyed about his video is that he went into detail on what he observed as far as the machine work from Canik and how he can tell where it's thick, where it's thin, what he can do work on, what parts, what areas that he can do. I mean, it's like he's really observant on the work that he does or what he can do or what as far as if it's too thin, he said that it may crack under pressure or over time. If he does, let's say, cut work down here or even like up here on this side right here, whatever they call it, the chamfered edge. But I really enjoy this piece right here. It looks really cool. I'm just really happy that we have someone in the industry that will take in the Canik's and start owning his work for them and recognizing that us as a community want to be able to customize our slides and our guns. If you don't know already, this entire Mete MC9 was purchased flat dark earth. I had no other option. I was looking for a black one, couldn't find one. The bitone is pretty cool, but I'm not really a big fan of the flat dark earth. So I asked him, I was like, go ahead and change the frame up. I think he knew he was gonna do that anyways. One thing that we did discuss is that he wanted to see if he can do some laser stipple work to it, but because it's so thin and you can tell, because the wall is so thin that it would not have been the right direction to go. I'm sure that there's other companies out there that will and are willing to do it. But what I enjoy about Mark is that he's really thorough and he thinks things out before he actually does the work. And he's like, well, is this gonna work? Nah, it's not gonna work. And he keeps everything safe. You know, he makes sure that his work is quality work, and you can tell, and I can tell right now just by the feel, the way that it's just changed this entire firearm for me. But it's beautiful. This is the brass backstrap from Taylor Freelance. Again, this is the Freedom Smith base pad. If you're interested, go see if you can find something from them. Can't wait to get this to the range, and I can't wait to, I've already ran it and it runs fine. I just want to make sure that it runs absolutely perfect before I start carrying it, because I got to throw some rounds through it. Like I said, I carry my executive right now, and that's been perfect for me. But yeah, I think I have maybe 100 rounds through this. And I know it's not a lot, but once I get this to the range, I'm probably going to do another 200 off the bat and then just take it with me, do 50 rounds every time I go to the range. And then what I want to do is run it hard at ETTS. It's a gun range out in Waxahachie where you can just run and gun. I wanted to let you guys know that this is the service now. Another thing about NC Engravers right now, today is what, November the 18th? 18th? Yeah. And this weekend, if you sign up right now and join their email list, they will, off of this service, take 20% off. So right now is the best time to go ahead and get yourself a discount and save yourself some coinage, because this doesn't come around for, as far as my understanding, the services or the discounts don't come around very often. If they do, it's probably two or three times a year. And right now is just, I think it's the last time for the year in order for you to enjoy a discount of 20% on the services that they are offering. Go ahead and join their email list. Again, that's ncengravers.com. I'm really happy with the way that this came out, and I can't wait to shoot it. Go check out the video on build and what he explains in further detail on what he observed and what he could and couldn't do, what he wanted to do, and maybe in the future what can be offered to this in addition to the windows, and the window being offered on any other Canik that he may think about down the road. Things change. Again, thank you for tuning in. Take care, and I'll see you next time.